And welcome back to Let's Play Star Trek.
We have arrived at the Cymkoe system in response to a distress call regarding Mertens' orbital station.
A final unity.
The station was apparently attacked by unknown forces, leaving it in danger of a power core breach.
Yeah, they want a warp core breach. That's no good.
We are within sensor range of the Mertens' orbital station, sir.
Thank you, Data.
On screen. Miss LaForge?
LaForge here.
Report. What is the condition of the station?
You're looking at what's left of the Mertens Orbital Station, one of the largest research centers in the Federation.
Yes, yes, we know that. It's not what he asked you.
The focus of their work is on power generation. 5 years ago, they built the prototype of an experimental power core, and it's been running the station ever since.
Power generation studies? That doesn't warrant an assault like this.
I've been in contact with Starfleet headquarters. Power generation is only part of what this station studies. For several years, researchers here have been working on new ways to detect cloaked vessels.
Someone doesn't want them to find that out.
If the Romulans discovered this, they might have risked a raid. The Cymkonians did not detect the attacking ship. It may have been cloaked.
That's speculation, Mr. Worf. We have no proof the Romulans were involved.
Well, whoever it was, something powerful punched through the station's shields and sliced off an entire research wing.
Damn.
What do you mean, sliced off?
Don't you ever have pizza, Riker?
There is insufficient debris in the area to indicate that the missing section was destroyed. It is possible the attackers simply removed it.
Geordi, could that be what destabilized the power core?
No, and that's what I can't figure out. Damage to the upper deck should only cause minor problems. But I'm reading serious power fluctuations. Maybe serious enough to breach the power core's containment field.
What will happen if the containment field fails?
Riker? Does boom mean anything to you?
I can't say for certain, but with the amount of energy that thing can put out, I wouldn't want to be around it when it goes.
Is there any way to shut down the core?
There's a fail-safe mechanism which is supposed to jettison the core automatically in an emergency.
I'd say this qualifies as an emergency. Why wasn't the core jettisoned?
Well, they were under attack, weren't they?
The only way to prevent it is by manual override. Someone has to be there to stop it.
That means there's someone still alive in there. Data, are you picking up any life signs?
The station's shielding is interfering with our sensors. I cannot tell if any of the crew are still alive. However, life support is still functioning. But power readings indicate that it may fail at any time.
Dr. Crusher.
Crusher here.
We are nearing Mertens Station. Are you prepared for casualties?
My staff is ready to do double shifts. We can handle about 330 emergency cases, but we'll have to beam the rest down to Cymkoe.
How many medical staff personnel does the Enterprise have? I didn't think it would be that much to handle 330 emergency cases at once.
Understood. What is your recommendation?
I don't know who he's asking.
We can't do anything from here, but to get an away team aboard, we have to find a way through those shields.
I believe I have a solution. The station's upper shields are badly damaged. If we establish a lock on a transporter on the upper decks, a transporter beam could penetrate the weakened shields.
Once we're in, we should be able to jettison the power core. Then we can lower the station's shields and evacuate the wounded.
Sounds like a plan.
Very well, number one. Make it so.
Geordi, I want you and the rest of the away team ready to go in 20 minutes.
We'll be there in 10.
Make it so. Make it so.
Counselor, do you have any thoughts?
I'm sorry, Captain, but I don't have any suggestions right now.
Mr. Data, any suggestions?
I suggest we...
This is all the same stuff they said before.
Any suggestions, number one?
I'm sorry, Captain.
Mr. Worf, your analysis.
Captain, we should check our orders from Starfleet.
Should we really talk to Starfleet?
Admiral Williams here. What?
What is the current situation, Admiral?
Actually, things are relatively quiet.
Okay, I don't see any option to tell them about what's going on.
Picard out.
So let's go to the transporter room. Okay, I'm gathering
down coordinates selected.
Okay, that's the station then. This automatically shows Riker, Crusher. I'm not sure what's going on with her face. She kind of looks like the guy from Mask. Geordi, LaForge, and Worf. Okay, and you could charge. You could. Well, not charge, but bring other people to. In or out of Karlstrom? Butler? Okay.
Beam down coordinates selected.
I don't think we can even change this stuff. Or it. Can we add anything? No, I guess not. Now how do I beam down? That's scanning for...
Beam down coordinates selected.
Oh! There we go. Cool! Alright, just like on the show. I didn't know you had to drag those up. That's pretty cool though. Loving this game so far. Okay, so... I've read the manual. Remembered some stuff. From what I can tell, this is where your basic adventure game mechanics come into play. You can look at things, you can take things, you can talk to people, and this is walking to certain areas. You can switch to whoever you want to control. Like so. This is pause and stuff, and you can use this equipment. Fire phaser at tricorder.
It's a phaser.
Tricorder. Mission objectives. Location, Mertens Orbital Station. Objective, stabilize life support, prevent power core breach, lower shields to permit evacuation. Station is center for power generation research. Power core is of experimental design. Station attacked by unknown foe. Core destabilized, endangering life support. Station is surrounded by protective shielding to contain power core fluctuations. Core must be stabilized or jettisoned before shields can be lowered to permit transporter evacuation. Oh, these are the last things we said. Okay.
It's a medical kit. Medical personnel use the medical tricorder to identify biological problems and determine treatment.
Mm-hmm. Now, of course, you know me. I'm gonna try to squeeze every bit of dialogue I can out of these people. Plus, it's interesting when they say stuff like this. It's a phaser.
It is a type 2 phaser, which produces a pulsed protonic charge.
Oh, that's...
The med kit is a collection of devices that allows medical personnel to determine body conditions and treat injuries.
Mm-hmm.
The medical tricorder uses sensors to provide detailed scans of body conditions.
Sensors. So we've got his... The previous two games, 25th Anniversary and Judgment Rights, got Spock saying sensors the whole time. I guess he did say that on the show, I don't remember. Well, now we got Worf who can take that place.
It's a phaser.
Oh, I keep hitting that.
I use the med kit to scan bodies and treat them if necessary. I use the medical tricorder to scan for body makeup, organ system function, diseases, and electromagnetic readings.
You know, body makeup, you don't use that until after the person's dead.
It's a type 2 phaser. It's a med kit. The medical tricorder uses active and passive scans to provide diagnostic readings of body process, organ function, diseases, and electromagnetic conditions.
Mm-hmm.
It's Lieutenant Worf, the ship's security chief. It's Commander Riker.
It's Commander Riker.
It's Lieutenant Worf.
Wait, I didn't... He's standing in front of her. Yep, I'm gonna make him move. So he can... wait. So he can look at Crusher.
Beverly Crusher is the ship's medical officer.
It's Beverly Crusher, the Enterprise chief medical officer. Lieutenant Worf is the ship's chief security officer.
Oh, they're all chief.
Geordi is the Enterprise's chief engineering officer.
We can't look at ourselves.
Wouldn't count on using this transporter with the power fluctuating so badly.
Commander Riker is the ship's second in command. Dr. Crusher is the Enterprise's medical officer.
Right.
It is Lieutenant Commander Geordi LaForge, chief engineering officer.
Very good.
It's Commander Riker.
The way she says it, like, you want me to explain who he is?
It's Lieutenant Worf, the ship's security chief. It's Lieutenant Commander Geordi LaForge. It's Commander Riker.
I was trying to look at...
I hope we can use this transporter to evacuate some wounded. We may not be able to lower the station's shields in time.
You hope so, don't you?
I don't recommend we send anybody through. With these energy fluctuations, any living matter could be severely distorted.
Then it'd be even more sick.
This transporter appears operational.
It says transporter panel.
I believe I can operate this console. Energy fluctuations have damaged several systems. Life support is functioning, but it will not be long before it fails. Energy flux...
Okay, I thought these might be three separate.
Energy fluctuations.
Same thing there. Transporter. I don't think we have a, you know, view all selectables type thing.
These power surges could threaten life support. We have to find a way to switch to emergency power. These transporter controls look like they're operational.
Alright. Geordi?
All primary subsystems are down. Inertial dampers, life support, no telling how long until these power surges overload the backups. We'd better hurry.
Well, yeah, we gotta look at everything first.
From this console, we can do point-to-point beaming inside the station's shields.
These power surges are serious. Without a stable power source, we'll lose life support. This is an unusual design for a transporter panel.
Okay, so what if we use the phaser on that?
I don't think that's the best thing to do.
Commander, I'm reading some serious power fluctuations in the life support systems.
How serious?
Well, we could lose life support at any time. We've got to find a stable power source, and soon.
Well, then we're doomed.
If life support fails, we won't have much time to stabilize the station.
I'm not done messing with everything.
Life support has to take priority. Let's get to the control room and see if we can switch life support over to emergency power. I don't think that's such a good idea.
Med tricorder.
He's perfectly healthy. I can't use this with that.
I can't use this with that.
She's perfectly healthy. He's fine.
Curious what we say.
I do not believe that I can use this with that. He is not injured.
They can't use it on themselves.
She is not injured. He is not injured.
He's fine. He's fine. He's fine.
He's fine.
It's not working.
He's fine. He's fine. She's fine. I can't make it work with that.
Alright. Let's go... So I can't actually use the tricorder on things? Well, I can. Use tricorder on transporter panel. Sufficient for operation. Cymkoe transporter. Systems check. Connection to sensors damaged. Energy fluctuations may disrupt buffer and damage pattern.
The systems check out, but the energy flow is highly unstable. I wouldn't use it unless we have to.
No unusual reading.
I think I just used it on itself.
The transporter may be too unstable to use. I'm reading severe energy surges.
I am reading dangerous energy levels in the transporter subsystem.
It's pretty neat seeing all the different things they say.
All readings are normal. Wait a minute. These energy levels are all over the scale.
So we can't use that.
These power surges could threaten life support.
Alright, let's go to the next room. Can we? How do we go to the next room? Oh, there's a door here.
There's nothing unusual here.
Alright, let's go through it.
It's not working.
The door is not working? Can we just walk that way? Yes. Oh, wow. We are really small, and there's somebody falling here. Trapped woman. Power conduits. Central shaft.
It looks like this shaft just goes on forever.
Hmm.
The experiments here must require a lot of energy. These look like high-capacity conduits.
Rather huge.
Anyone caught under that heavy cable when it fell could be seriously hurt.
So we got three things to look at then. Trap woman.
It's Lieutenant.
Oh, there's a catwalk.
We can use that catwalk to cross over the conduits, but we'd better watch our step.
She does her moves on the catwalk.
I've got to talk to the engineers who built this place. The entire hull is lined with a liquid tritanium-duranium alloy in a memory gel suspension. It's completely self-sealing.
Nice echo on Geordi's voice. I didn't notice it on the doctor's.
You mean the station heals itself?
Well, I hear that now.
That's one way to put it. The attack caused major structural damage. If this were any other station in the Federation, we'd be standing in a vacuum. I'd sure like to get a look at that power core. One of these conduits could handle the entire energy output of the Enterprise.
The echo disappeared.
That cable must be over 1,000 kilograms. We've got to get her out of there.
It looks like the only way across. The experimental power core must produce tremendous amounts of energy. Looks like this goes all the way to the power core. It looks like she's still alive, but she's pinned under that cable.
Right. I don't think we got Geordi looking at this.
If the turbolifts are out, this shaft is the only access to engineering. But we'd never be able to climb down there in time.
Well, then you might have to jump.
The catwalk is the only way across the conduits.
True that.
Majka. It is a triply redundant energy system. Even after a direct assault, the station is still operational.
Impressive.
Stand clear of the edge. This shaft does not have safeguards against falling. She is trapped beneath that fallen cable. We must free her.
All right, let's go. Walking on the catwalk. She does your moves on the catwalk. Do I have to send everyone there individually? Can we... wait. Alright, we can all start moving that way. This is a really huge area. Weird design with this going on here as well. So the medical... medical tricorder.
She's got multiple fractures in both legs. The bones in the lower part of her left leg are shattered. She's in shock and there's some internal bleeding.
Pretty messed up.
All things considered, she's very lucky. I can take care of the worst of her injuries here, but I'd like to get her to sickbay. It's not working.
Don't they say anything different? Look at next room.
How kind of... The experiments here must require a lot. There's nothing unusual here. We can use that catwalk to cross over the conduit. Anyone caught under that heavy cable when it...
That's what she said before.
Looks like that was their primary communications line. That would explain why they couldn't answer our hails.
Hmm, indeed. Trap woman.
That cable must be over 1,000 kilograms. We've got to get her out of there.
It looks like she's still alive, but she's pinned under that cable. With all the damage this station suffered, I'm surprised it's still holding together.
For now.
She is trapped beneath that fallen cable. We must free her. This cable was severed by weapons fire, probably during the attack.
Anyone caught on...
Alright. I don't know if we can move this cable, but let's see if we can use the med kit on her. Not on Crusher. On
I
her.
Can't do anything for her until we get that cable out of the way.
Okay, I gotta move the cable. I don't think we can do that with our bare hands.
If we move the cable, we may injure her. There must be another way to get her free.
Shoot both ends off with the phaser?
The heat from the vaporized cable killed her. She might still be alive if we'd been more careful.
Wow. I think I should do that over.
The heat from the vaporized...
She's dead. Those data transfer cables are made of a highly conductive material. The energy from our phaser fire must have transferred to her.
That's sad.
She was too close when the cable vaporized. It was a risk we had to take.
Was it?
She is dead.
That's all that Worf says. I gotta reload. I'll see you guys back here. Okay, I'm back. I forgot we could actually talk to ourselves.
We have to find the life support panel. It's probably in the main control room.
According to the schematics, the life support controls are up in station administration.
Let's get up to the station's control center. We have to stabilize life support.
Right. And Crusher?
We have to find the life support.
There may be an auxiliary life support panel below in engineering. We could stabilize it from there.
According to the schematics, the life support controls are up in station administration.
So I think they all say the same thing?
There may be an...
We have to find the life support...
Again, Worf's in the way.
Let's get up to the station's control center. We have...
Okay, we're gonna go stabilize life support. Alright. If you contact the ship... I tried it... before. You just end up going back to the ship. So you can't really talk to them, it just brings you back. Alright, so... Oh, do the door.
That's the passage we came in through.
That's our only way off this station. We can only beam out from the transporter we used to get here.
Mm-hmm.
The way back to the transporter is over there behind those conduits.
Dr. Crusher is the... We will have to return that way to reach the transporter room.
What do you think, guys?
There's no need for that.
Oh, you can't talk to yourself.
These data lines are pretty volatile. I'd be very careful about using a phaser to cut it.
Now you tell me.
I don't like it. But a phaser may be the only way to get to her.
Don't think so.
Perhaps we could cut through the cable with a phaser.
Hmm.
We may be able to cut her free with a phaser, but we'll have to be very careful.
How do we be fair? Talk to the next room.
It didn't work.
Yeah. Let's see if we can find something else. I don't know if there's a different way to cut it. Farther away from her? I'm not even sure. Okay.
If the turbolifts are out, this shaft is the... I don't see anything special about it.
Turbolift.
Boy, this place was built to last. Even with major structural damage, basic systems are still functional. Even the turbolifts.
Mm-hmm.
I'd sure like to get a look at that power core.
I think that's the same thing they've been saying.
At least this turbolift still works.
The turbolift appears functional, but I would advise caution.
But of course.
Well, this turbolift works. That's a hopeful sign.
Guess we're going in the turbolift. I think they will automatically... If we go in, they'll choose us. Oh, administration and engineering. It's probably engineering we have to go to, but let's try administration. Ah, interesting. Control panel.
It's been badly damaged by power surges.
Window.
There's nothing unusual here.
Holo table.
The holo table's not working.
This control panel.
It's been badly damaged by power surges.
It's the same thing she said here, right?
It's been bad.
Yeah.
Well, this turbo lift works.
Same thing she said before.
A lot of these systems are out. I don't see anything special about it. Looks like a power surge knocked out the holotable. I could fix it if we had more time. Or if I had a flux router, I could bypass the damage completely.
A flux router? Is that anything like a flux capacitor?
It's dead. Power surges have disabled most of the station's primary systems. A lot of these systems are out.
He does say different things there.
Energy surges have fused these controls. Energy surge. With the holotable out, we can only get damage reports on life support and power systems.
These controls are useless. They are too badly damaged. These controls. We did not come here for sightseeing.
Gotta love Worf.
This holotable is damaged. A full damage report will not be possible without it.
Can we analyze it?
This holotable is damaged. No unusual readings. These controls are useless.
I don't know what we can do with what around here.
This holotable is damaged. These controls are useless.
Can we walk off the screen? Well, this is administration, and that's all we can do. Alright.
Life support will fail if we don't get it stabilized soon. Once it fails, we won't have much time.
Mm-hmm.
The only person I've seen so far is that woman we found earlier.
That's the only person that all of us have seen, Riker.
I can't just let that woman suffer. We have to find a way to get her free.
If we revive the injured woman, she may be able to tell us about the attack.
Well, even though we can't free her, maybe we can still talk to her. Walk to Worf. Wait, where do we come in? Here? Ah. I guess we came from Crew Deck 2. Walk to next room. Do we have like a run option available? We didn't try talking to her.
There's no need for that.
Well, there's no need for it, so.
I can't do anything for her until we get that cable out of the way. If we move the cable, we may injure her. There must be another way to get her free.
Maybe we can find something in engineering.
I've never seen anything like it.
Huh, interesting. Strange machine.
I've never seen anything like it.
Well, yeah. Damaged conduit.
The damage to that conduit looks pretty severe. There's nothing unusual here.
No?
Well, this turbo lift works.
Anything else to look at? Core control room?
There's nothing unusual.
Power conduits?
The experiments here must require a lot of energy. These look like high-capacity conduits.
Amazing. It's using a plasma suspension beam to draw energy straight out of the main conduits. I'd say that alien machine cut through the conduit casing to get at the energy inside.
I'd say we've found our intruder. The experimental power core must produce tremendous amounts of energy.
I believe this is one of the attackers. There are weapon ports on both sides of its hull. Majka.
Okay. On that note, thanks for watching, guys. See you next time when we try to figure out what to do with this thing. Endure. And enduring, grow strong.